How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Wolf Around, and it's great to see you here. In this video, I'll show you how to always install the latest NVIDIA drivers by downloading them from NVIDIA's official driver download page. Subscribe to the channel, join the pack, you are always welcome here. Without further ado, let's get started. If you are watching this video, I'll assume you have freshly installed a Linux distribution and need to install your NVIDIA driver. If that's the case, the first thing you need to do is install updates. Open a terminal and type this command. This will install the latest updates. Now you are seeing NVIDIA's driver download page. But before downloading the driver, we need to check which GPU is installed in your system. To do that, open a terminal and type lspci. This command lists PCI devices on your PC. Find your GPU in the lists. Mine is GeForce 940MX. Now we can download the driver. Fill in these fields according to your GPU. And click the Find button. The results will show you the latest release channel driver. You should always verify that you are downloading a release channel driver. To do this, check the info section. If it shows a plain NVIDIA logo without a beta tag, it's a release driver. If it says beta here, do not download or install it. Beta drivers are often unstable and may harm your system. I'm emphasizing this because, as of the date I'm recording this video, NVIDIA hasn't released Linux drivers for the RTX 5060 Ti GPUs. So, if you want to set up an RTX 5060 Ti on your Linux system, you'll have to wait for the release version. You can also browse older versions by clicking the All section. Now click the View button. After that, the Download button will appear. But before downloading, let's check which GPUs are supported in this version. Click the Supported Products tab and search for your GPU. Double-checking this can prevent you from downloading an incompatible driver, especially if your GPU is older like mine. For example, my GeForce 940MX is still supported. If it wasn't, I would need to pick an older driver version. This particular version even supports the RTX 5090, but not the RTX 5060 Ti. So it's always important to check. The layout of these pages may change over time, but the information you need to check will remain similar. Now click the Download button and wait for the download to complete. Once it's finished, remember the path you saved the installer. We'll use it later. Before installing the driver, there are a few important steps. Disabling the nano driver and installing the required dependencies. Most Linux distributions use the nano driver for NVIDIA GPUs by default. In my opinion, nano is only good for keeping the screen alive. Installing the real NVIDIA driver is much better choice in terms of power efficiency, performance, and compatibility. To disable nano, we'll follow the official guide from NVIDIA. Open a terminal and follow along. First, run this command to check if the nano driver is still active. If you see an output like this, it means nano is active. To disable it, we need to blacklist it. Let's navigate to the configuration directory. You will see existing files there, but the nano blacklist file hasn't been created yet. Create it with this command. Now open the configuration file you created with this command. And copy and paste these two lines. Make sure there is at least one empty line at the end. Press Ctrl S to save, then Ctrl X to exit. Now apply the configuration with this command. Before rebooting, we need to install some dependencies. Run this command. Next, we need to disable the graphical interface, so we can install the NVIDIA driver properly. Run this command. Now reboot your PC by typing sudo reboot. After rebooting, you will see a screen with just a terminal. Enter your username and password to login. Then type sudo-i to switch to the root user. Now remember the path where you downloaded the installer. Navigate to that directory. Use ls command to verify you are in the right place. You should see the installer's file name. Run this command to make the installer an executable. Finally, run the installer just by adding .and/ at the beginning of its file name. Now just follow along with my choices. Once the installation is complete, use this command to re-enable the graphical interface. Then reboot your PC by typing reboot. Let's confirm everything is working properly. First, check if novo is disabled. Run this command again. If nothing appears, it's disabled. Now type nvidia-smi. If you see a table showing GPU stats, it means the driver is installed and working correctly. I'm a software engineer specializing in computer graphics, game development, GPU hardware acceleration, AI inference, and cross-platform C++ development. I look forward to sharing more insights with you. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.